Yes, teams on 10, big show. We beam in a couple of Tiger Cubs from the hub. We kick off our own lockdown league, and teams on 10 confronts a bully. Yes, it is. Teams on 10. Nick Butler alongside the former Blue and Giant and now podcasting superstar Dilly Buckley. How are you, mate?
How are you, Nicky?
Good, mate. A bit going on in footy.
It is. It's been a big, big week.
Bucks and the Blues and all that.
Yeah. No, it's been huge. I'm honestly looking forward to debunking it with you tonight.
I will have a chat to you about the Blues and I'll get you to put your serious hat on in the next break. But first, hey, the pod's going well.
It is, yeah. It's been number one in the charts and number one in the hearts of Australia for the last sort of 12 months.
You had Howie on?
Yeah, I did.
Channel 10 man?
Yeah, I did, yeah. He's a good Channel 10 man. No, we did off air. We didn't quite make the cut, but he definitely was speaking about you a lot. Sort of like stopped calling him and stuff.
All right, mate. leave the funny stuff to the big guy, mate. Big guy with a beard. Hey, serious Blues news later, but first, the really real headline stuff is what got your juices flowing.
Yes, okay. Well, first one for me was a pie that has been out of the game for a long time. We sort of forgot about how good this player was. Jamie Elliott. Absolute star. Kicked four goals in the first quarter against the Crows on the weekend. Ended up with six. And he quickly reminded, as Charlie Cameron said, who is one of the premier small forwards in the comp. Do you remember how good Jamie Elliott was at the start of his career?
I did. Good Euroa boy. Beautiful lead, strong hands and a beautiful kick.
So hard to match up on. Just a quick fact about Jamie Elliott as well. He was actually picked up by the Giants as a 19-year-old and then on-traded to Collingwood. So it's a very interesting story, good pathway. Good to see him back and hopefully, fingers crossed, he can stay fit.
Good juice. I like it. Now, I've got a couple, and I'm going a bit off Broadway for my juices, going out to the expanses of footy. So, during lockdown on Saturday, I was flat as a tack, right? I just got flat, and I was thinking, I need a coaching rev up. I need a life rev up. Like, I was bringing everyone down. So, I thought, I'm going to look for a rev up. And I just went through Twitter, and thank you to the ABC for tweeting this, because it just so happened. It was like divine intervention.
Twitter's not the normal place I go for a pump up, by the way. It's actually where I go to feel a lot worse
about myself. Anyway, so this popped up. His name is Shane Lennon. He's from Colin Gully up there in the Riverina, and it's a great old-fashioned pump up, and let's let it roll now. Thank you.
Take the game on! Have courage and confidence in your own ability and your team to make your point! Self-belief, trust, if it is to be, it's up to me.
Come on.
If it is to be, it's up to me.
Come on.
Lessons are learned, trophies are earned. Let's go out there and do each other proud.
And I was back. I got some bloody DP'd and did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How good was that?
That gave me anxiety watching that. And by the way, good Perryman family up in Colin Gully.
Isn't Harry that in the front?
I think
or the
that
brother?
Was, one of the brothers, in the front. So fantastic. I do feel like that was maybe 10 years ago, though, and shot on a Nokia 3315. But it was still very
regardless,
good
I think we'll get Shane Lennon on. He is my kind of guy. I know the millennials aren't into getting yelled at and spat on and all that, but that got me going.
Well, maybe.
That got me through lockdown. So good on you. I think his name's Sparky. Good on you, Sparky Lennon. Colin Gully. Maybe we could play for Colin Gully.
What's your next juice?
Righto, next one. I'm getting told to move on. Harry Taylor last week. So I had his... tweeted out. I've got to get off the Twitter a bit. No. But put up on social media his pledge to himself that he used to try to make a contract that he'd commit every week. Well, he's still upholding the contract. He's gone out to his local club and kicked 11, if you don't mind. So let's have a look at Harry just in the burbs and doing very nice things at Northampton. So it's a little bit grainy too, but I can tell you this was only on the weekend. So old HT he's living the values.
He looks like he's
just dominating. Look at that.
Taller than anyone at that ground.
he's loving it.
He's absolutely
he was double cobbering and getting right rounded, and he would have enjoyed his furfies because he's gone and kicked 11. And
what a star.
Some blokes just love playing.
He got
footy.
The number 7 as well, which is good. Some poor bloke's been dropped for that. It's unfortunate.
Yeah. No, yeah, Harry can do what he wants.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah. Hey, moving on, Nicholas. So that was a great juice. Well done this
week. Thank you. Are you taking the pee or did you like my juice?
A little bit. this week, though, big news is the Neds level youngster who has caught my eye. I love this segment. We all love the segment. The fans love it. They've been messaging me. They've been DMing saying, bring it back. We love it. Didn't go anywhere, but I want it even more. This week, we had young Spargo from the Demons. And isn't he fantastic? He's dominating at the moment. Obviously, Cozzy Pickett is getting a lot of praise up there, but this man's doing a lot of hard work, tackling his pressure. He uses the ball so well. And I don't know what the stats are, but in terms of goal assists, it's got to be up there with the highest in the team. I feel like he would be involved in every score chain because everything he touches turns to gold. Love him.
Yeah, that's him. Oh, you know, I was coached by his old man. And there
that
was
has bit, nothing to do
no,
with
No, there is.
That has
I'm
nothing
telling
to
you,
do with the
don't
segment.
Don't find me for this. Yeah. I'll tell you, there was a bit of Shane Sparky Lennon in his old man.
Okay.
A bit of lessons are learned. Trophies are in. Get off Butler, your weakest piss sort of stuff. He used to get done a bit. Mm. So, good day, Paul, if you're there. Good, he's a good fella.
Yes.
Paul Spugger. Yeah. Anyway, I'm getting told to wind up after that. Lots more teams on 10, some serious news and some lockdown league. It's back. Let's compete and sniff the deep heat and all that stuff. This is Teams on 10. Teams on 10 is proudly brought to you by Furphy Refreshing Ale. Unbelievable.
Oh, Nicky Boy, we're back. What a start. What a good start to the show.
Good pickup.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I'm very good at that these days. Hey, you know what our show is about? Social media.
It is.
We love the fans. We love the young kids. We're hip. We're cool.
Yeah.
A lot of DMs come in, probably thousands a week, and they're all positive.
A lot of Facebook ratings. Zuckerberg's been on again. We're breaking the algorithm.
They're all positive. And if you want to send one through, it's at 10sportau on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, the like. But sometimes, Nicky Boy, there is some feedback that we need to address. And we do have a DM this week.
Yep.
And it's feedback. It's at @legend_troll_Maltese.
Okay.
He says, hey, guys, love the show. After watching the show on Facebook last week, I read some of the comments after and there was been a lot of trolling of you guys.
Yes.
Maybe you should start reading out all your mean comments. Some of it's pretty spot on. Just a thought.
There might be a few more after that read.
Yeah, that was terrible. That was terrible.
Can we get an audio book of
that
Dylan's
was
read?
Terrible.
No, that's okay. I don't really get it. So, yeah, we get trolled a bit. I have feelings too. I get trolled.
I tell you every week, do not read the comments. And what do? You call me and you say, Nick, someone is saying some rude things about me.
I did. I got one. It was actually screenshotted by my brother and sent to me. So that's not very nice, by the way. But some guy said, who's the loser host who's rocking...
That's you.
The 2002 haircut.
That's you, I think.
Well, I was thinking it might be you.
No, it's definitely...
Could it be you? Because you're doing a bit of a... Anyway,
I'd definitely say it's you, to be honest. Yeah.
I had pretty nice hair last week. I was a bit shattered. I had to go and get Shane Lennon out again
That's one of the better comments I've read, to be honest.
What is a 2002 haircut is what I want to know. Is that fair? Do I have a 2002 haircut?
Yeah, a little bit. But it's good. You're sticking to it. Because it'll come back in fashion soon.
Well, I went through the archives to troll.
This is going to be $50. This is $50.
So I was thinking, what is a 2002 haircut? So I rolled through the archives of State League football. There's a bit of a State League footy Hall of Fame. And that is an 02 haircut right there. That's the David Beckham with the tips. So
Jesus.
I don't know.
Plenty in the stands there, rocking up to watch you play. Who's that? Art Moma, is it? That's fantastic.
That's at the G. Anyway, let's go to that one too. To that flog, that's how my hair was in 2002.
Ills kick at half time, was it?
Are you right, mate? Is it you? Have you got a burner account? Is it you? Anyway, was that good? My mum gave me that photo. Was that a good gag? Did
it's
go well?
A good photo. It's a good
it
photo.
Was good. David Beckham, I'll tell you, I was going pretty well back then.
You are. Yeah. You are. Hey, you know someone who isn't going too well at the moment? It's something close to my heart. It is the Blues.
Yep.
I know you wanted to ask some hard-hitting questions. What have you got?
Not really, but there is a bit going on in footy when you take into account Nathan Buckley and now the Blues. Firstly, all going on at the Blues with this review. And the Carlton faithful are getting cranky. Let's cut to it. We're not a hard news show, but you've been there and you're in an educated position. What do you think of the coach? Is David Teague the right man to be there for another 3 years?
Look, it's so hard for me to comment on this. And one thing I always knew when I finished footy was I was never going to comment on things that I don't know.
Yep.
I haven't had David Teague as a coach. From all reports, all the boys love him.
Okay.
But I honestly think it's not the coach's problem. It's not the player's problem. It's a holistic problem of not knowing how to win. There's not enough players there that have been brought up in a winning culture. And that's at no fault of anyone's, but the circumstance of the club over the last sort of 10 years. How do you fix that? I actually don't know. I don't have the answers to that. But it's not knowing how to win games. You see the boys are losing these games by 20 points. They're always in it. They nearly win it. Yep. They win some of them, but most of them they lose by 20 points when they should be winning.
Right. How do you change the culture then?
As I said, I honestly don't know.
Million-dollar question, is it?
I really haven't been a part of a winning culture myself, so I don't think I'm the right person to answer.
You were on the Giants list when they made a grand final.
Yeah, it's a little bit
different. What's the difference between that and where the... Well, that's probably too simplistic.
Yeah, it is a little bit different. They're two completely different clubs. One was a young club that, you know, they had some really high-level talent. They get momentum and they play some good footy. Carlton has not had momentum for a long time. So I think you do need to grab someone like Brisbane have done.
Yep.
Those players that come out of these, like, unreal teams.
Do they need a Luke Hodge type?
Maybe they do. Someone like that. We said last week, Jack Rewalt from Richmond.
Yep.
He's... That, you know, it was said that should they do that and trade him on so that Coleman Jones can play some good footy. Well, if they did, the Blues should be the first team they're locking to try and get some success through the door to teach these young kids.
Okay, so can you summarise that in 30 seconds? Do you think David Teague will be there next year?
I do. I think he will be there next year. I think it's on the list management, on these players, to get some players in that have played in successful teams for a long time. They grow up knowing how to win and they're more senior players that can actually help out.
Absolute final one, because we've got to get to the lockdown league. There is an accusation they play selfish footy. Is that wrong?
Well, I just think that when you don't know how to win, you go into self-preservation mode. We've all been there. We've all played in teams when we're not feeling confident.
Yep.
You don't know if you're going to be in the team next week. You don't know if you're going to get dropped. So you try and play the best yourself. A lot of things goes on in your mind when you're trying to win games of AFL footy and you're not feeling safe. And that's what a lot of those players are not feeling safe at the moment.
OK, so maybe it's not that broken. Hey, good chat. I love when we get a bit serious,
yeah,
talk to you, because you are a bit of a deep footy thinker. So good luck to the Blues. Hopefully that review comes up with a few answers. Hey, time for us to get a bit silly again, and it's lockdown.
Do you want to do this?
Yeah, I do. It's lockdown league time. Time for me to get the old red jacket off, and we're going to play some football.
Here we are. It is the lockdown league, an event that we named 2 weeks ago when we thought we might have been in lockdown for a little bit longer. Looking back, retrospect is a hell of a thing, and maybe we could have thought of a better name. But tonight, the name of the game is the handball game. It's going to be 2 minutes on the clock, three handballs on the right, three handballs on the left. Higher score wins. The more they get through, the more points they can win. We're going to kick off with Dill. Have the ball in here. Here we go.
Thank you. So sorry, did you get that?
Boo.
Bit of skill work there by Dill. First shot.
Yuck.
That's nothing there. No points there, unfortunately.
Thank you. Oh, there we go again.
Build up. Ooh, that's a six. Not six
bad.
Points
not
on
bad.
The board
not
there
bad.
For Dill.
Not bad. Not bad.
Nick looking nervous early.
Not really.
And that's another six. 12 points there. That's it. Nick is now up.
No, that's actually 13, isn't it?
Three on the right. No,
get him
no
off.
Point.
Get him off. Get him off. Get him off. Get him off.
Points there.
Fantastic. Tiny danger. I'm 6 foot six.
Nick's, right. Nick's here. First handball. That's a 1-pointer there for Nick. 1 point.
Shut
that's
up.
A slow
Shut
start.
Him up, please.
Could be the tortoise in the hare
situation.
You're
a ruckman. All you meant to do is handball.
That's
true. Second handball in.
Yeah,
that's a six.
Winning
Nick up to 7 points there.
Oh, what's with there the rolling of the balls?
Last one. Slow and steady here.
Oh, my God.
That's
I almost missed
pointer.
The thing.
So we've got
that was terrible. That's terrible.
Eight.
Get me off. Get me
so
off.
So here we go. Moving on now. Dill back to the ball.
Get
on
me
the
some
left
Shane
hand,
Lennon. Get me some Shane Lennon.
Hands.
Lessons learned. Oh,
that's a 1-pointer there again.
Yeah, no, not really.
Was that? Are you all right?
No, I'm not.
Lessons learned. Trophies earned.
That's, yes. Oh, slid it in there for a six. That was sneaky along the side there. Last one on the left. Ooh, and that's another 1-pointer.
You need three to win, really.
And we've got 30 seconds on. Big, just over 30 seconds on the clock here.
Big guys aren't
Nick
good.
Nick can
on
take
the left.
His time.
No, big guys aren't good.
Oh,
oh that's low. That's nothing. No points
really
there.
I have to move that actually a bit closer.
It's further than I thought.
Next one in. Here we go.
Oh, get
oh
in.
That's a 1-pointer there.
I win.
Needs the big six here.
No,
to
tired.
Even be in, could
no,
we? 15
all,
seconds on the clock here to use.
Yeah!
That's a sixer. And there we have it. Even with that last-ditch attempt, unfortunately, Nick won't be able to make it there. Dill finishing on 20. Nick all the way back in 2002 on 15. We'll be back with next week, the Lockdown League. It's coming back.
Piss off, Reese. If you're lucky we're in COVID times, mate, I'll be getting Shane Mumford on your ass. I'm going to hang my head in shame. This is Teams on 10. Couple of Tiger Cubs coming up. How embarrassing. Teams on 10 is brought to you by Neds. Take it to the Neds level. Yes, welcome back to Teams on 10. Well, the Tigers are roaring after Saturday night and what is a scary prospect for the rest of the comp. It's the young players driving it, and two of their young guns have beamed in now. Noah Balta and Hugo Ralphsmith. Hello, boys. Thanks for beaming in from Sydney.
How are we?
G'day. What's going on?
Hey, good. Hey, Nora, I'll start with you. Gee, that was a bit of a double cobra flex to the rest of the competition on Saturday night that you guys aren't going anywhere for a while.
Yeah, definitely. Just spoke about having, you know, not premierships aren't won early in the year. So, yeah, we're really excited just learning about other teams and what they're trying to do. Take some good things off what other people are doing, like Melbourne and Bulldogs, and try to implement that in our game. So over the long run, we, ideally get better. And, we save it all for the grand final.
Oh, I like it when you're talking about grannies already. It seems like a lot of the momentum is being driven by the youth. I touched on it on the top there. Gee, that's a good sign for you if, the senior players are still doing their part, but it doesn't look like that they're being relied upon every week. Is that fair?
Yeah, I think definitely. Over the past, the years I've been here, especially I got here in end of 2017 after they just won the grand final. And I think what the older boys said the most is what drove them was the young boys starting off, because we come back 3 weeks earlier than the older boys. And you're loving watching your highlights. You can't get his eyes off it. Definitely. Because they get back so much earlier, they drive the culture, the attitude that's going on. And as soon as, the older boys get back, everything's already there, so they just come in, feel at home, and we have a great pre-season and on from there.
Boys, it's still, you're obviously back in the hubs, you're in Coogee Bay, staying out of trouble. What have you been doing to keep busy up there?
It's been a little bit tough because we've been a bit restricted as you'd expect, but we've been going on walks, going down to the beach, having a swim, doing some exercise, stuff like that. Also got a big table tennis table down in the main room, so that's been getting abused a bit. But, that's about it.
Hugo, these are the hard-hitting questions here, mate. I know the Tigers, you guys start at high numbers. I think from memory, Noah, you were 48. You went to 21, I think. Hugo, you're 45 at the moment. Tell me now, honestly, you've got your eyes on someone's number. Who is it and what is it?
There's definitely a free spot at 13 after Hugo's booted off, so... maybe something like that, but no, I'm very happy at number 45, taking the reins off Nash, who've moved up to number 6. So I'm feeling right at home.
It does look good on you, mate. It looks very, very good on you. But I do like 13 as well. Noah, you're big in the cryptocurrency, my friend. You're looking very intelligent. Mine's taking an absolute beating. Have you got a tip for me?
Do I have a tip? Nah. Well, if any of mine were going pretty good, I'd let you know. But currently, I don't have any tips. Yeah, we'll leave that to the YouTubers that I watch that aren't that good either, apparently. But I think I've got in a bit too late. But no, it's going all right. I bought him back in November. I just love looking at it. It's just a bit of fun on the side, just to keep me occupied.
Is there one of the boys at the club that just thinks they know everything about it when realistically they know nothing, or is that you?
It's that's me. We also have a fellow, Hayden Hill, who's the statistic fella, and he's actually good at it. He's been doing it for a while now, and he told everyone, and nobody listened, and now they're asking him questions. What's going on?
Hey, Hugo, you're still a baby. You don't have to worry about crypto just yet. You can play with your mullet and just enjoy it all. Who are you gravitating towards? Who are the senior players that you're just trying to follow around a bit and learn the ropes from at the moment?
Well, I think Jack Rewalt, he's been a really big influence on me. He's always in my ear telling me stuff to do, stuff I'm doing well, stuff I'm doing not so well. He's definitely one that I probably admired before coming to the club and admire even more since I got here. Obviously, there's the obvious like Trent Cotchin and Dustin, who are obviously stars of the game. Is the main one.
Yeah, all pretty good names, mate. You've warmed my heart already too, that you really like watching your highlights. How much of a thrill that it was a beautiful goal you kicked against the Crows. You must just be buzzing, getting a taste of it and coping with the tempo and lapping it up.
Yeah, no, definitely. Absolutely loving it. It was, good first taste. It's a bit distracting putting it on.
you just watch. We'll talk amongst ourselves. While you're watching Hugo, Furphy Refreshing Ales are a big supporter of ours, and they're also a big supporter of the Tigers, and they're all about the unbelievable tales in footy. If you need a bit of a sounding board, I like to tell that I once got a bit physical with Shane Mumford on the track, and it didn't go well. A lot of people find it boring. I think it's good. Noah, can I start with you? Were you, I know you've told this a bit, but were you sort of legally blind pretty much for a while and weren't taking too many marks and you worked out you couldn't see? Is that rubbish or has that got too much mayo on it?
It's a bit of both. I'm not actually legally blind, so in perspective, so I've got an astigmatism, which I think it's negative sevens legally blind and I'm negative six in one eye, negative five. So I'm not legally blind, but I cannot see.
But so what happened? You got the specs or you got it fixed up?
I had scleral lenses in my TAC year, which are basically because the soft contacts wouldn't sit on my eye properly because the astigmatism basically the cornea, I can't remember, but of your eye is a bit bumpy. So the soft contacts and hard contacts playing footy didn't really work too well. So I tried scleral lenses, which go over the eye and it's like a suction cup. So basically a tee when you play golf, I had to put the contact on that, fill it up with solution and whack it in. And then after the game, I'd have like red eyes. So and that hurt a fair bit. So I just scrapped it and been playing without it my whole life. So, yeah.
Well, that is unbelievable. You've taken the furphy there. Well, whatever's happened there, mate, it's worked because you're going beautifully and you're on fire. So, boys, thank you so much for giving us a bit of time. And you don't go away empty-handed. You get the best prize pack in footy. You might have to share a few of these because of our budgets. But you get a one-year unlimited wash club membership thanks to Magic Hand Car Wash. Magic Wash Club's cleaner, safer and faster. You get a power drill thanks to Icon Construction, a new Icon. A $50 breakfast voucher at Cheeky Monkey Cafe on Swan Street. A one-on-one Pilates session at Motion Health. Turak, a slab of Furphy Refreshing Ale, unbelievable. A neighbour seller, Shiraz, and the Smash It hair product for the feathers. That can go to you, Hugo.
Beautiful, unreal.
Good on you, boys, and good luck in the West on
Sunday.
Thanks,
boys.
Beautiful, thank you.
Thanks for having us.
There we go. Love the young boy energy.
We do. Energy.
And he was, that's pretty amazing about the old... eyesight.
Yeah, I didn't realise.
Maybe
it was
a mind check.
There was probably a few other problems as well, I think.
I think so. It's very, very good player and going very nicely, the Tigers. All right, rolling in to round 13, and let's put our beanies on, please, because it's a very special weekend in footy. Big Freeze number 7.
Yes.
Fight MND. We'll come back to that in just a moment. But let's start with Port and Geelong on Thursday night.
Geelong.
Sydney Hawthorn.
I'm going Sydney.
Frio Gold Coast.
This is a big game. I think Frio will win this. It's at home.
A lot of injuries.
Yeah. Yeah. I still rate their young talent as the second best in the AFL.
Yeah, fair enough. St Kilda and Adelaide.
St Kilda will win this. They'll bounce back, even though they might not field a team this week.
Okay. North and GWS?
GWS. But this is a big game. North are very good at Bloodstone, and I feel like this would be a good test, but the Giants will win. I think Toby Green... hopefully gets up for this too.
Yes, yeah, we love Tobe. The Eagles and the Tigers.
Big game. This is actually a very big game, but I think the boys will get it done, the Tigers.
Potentially could have asked a few more footy questions to the boys rather than cryptocurrency, but that's okay. And the big one, Melbourne, Collingwood, the big freeze at the SCG. Now, quickly, get your beanies at Coles, Bunnings or fightmnd.org. $20, just fantastic. What a brave man Neil Danaher is. And a pretty big game of footy all of a sudden with Bucks giving it away.
Yeah, he's a star. So I'm very excited for that. Neil Danaher is an inspiration for motor neuron disease and very looking forward to it. I think the D's will win this one and it'll be a beautiful day.
It is the beast. Neil's a legend. That is Teams on 10. Enjoy yourself. Buy a beanie. See you next week.